Hello.
Okay, all right, we are finally back after, what, six weeks, I think, or something like that, since the last time we filmed.
No way. Really?
It's been a long time. We had...
I've been putting stuff out there on Facebook.
Yeah, she has, but the official video, yeah, it's been a while. We had 3 weeks of a family come and visit, which we were happy to have them, but obviously when they were here, we didn't do as much work, and then... We've just been kind of crazy. Molly's been traveling and just been busy. We have been getting stuff done, probably not nearly at the pace that we wanted to, but we're making strides.
We are.
We're doing better now. So,
we're doing good.
Yeah. And then, so first, let's show you what we've done kind of in the backyard. Not really much, but there have been some changes for the backyard. So we'll take you around for that and show you that before we show you inside. All right, so... Since the last time we filmed, we did have a hurricane come through. It was very mild for us and not a lot of issues. But first thing was we had all this cleaned out. Molly did a great job cleaning out some of these branches, just kind of clearing the way for us a little bit, making it easier for us. And then a couple of days after the storm, we realized that one of our trees actually blew over in the backyard. So you can see how open this makes it look with the tree that's gone. There's the stump there. The stump was left, but that tree had fallen over the back fence rail,
right in the middle of both of those fences.
Yeah, by that big palm there. And so we kind of worked a little bit to get it cleared out, but it made a huge difference. And that's about all that we've done so far in terms of like clearing out the backyard.
But
yeah, so we did something over there on the other side, but
wait,
also...
We did this?
Molly did that. But we just got a phone call this afternoon, which is super exciting. We were talking about getting this backyard cleaned out, and I also was, like, been terrorized by poison ivy. I've had, like, 3 rounds of steroids. It's been insane because we have poison ivy in one little section in the back. My uncle on Facebook was like, hey, yeah, you should go get some goats and get the goats cleared out. Well, we saw a thing in Jacksonville where there's someone who does like goats on the go, and we reached out to them and I called them today. She's actually going to come and look next weekend
and see if our yard qualifies for the goats to come and chew up all of this greenery.
Yeah, so
they can have it all.
She's going to come and take a look and see
let's trade it for goat poop.
Oh, 100%. If it's worth them bringing goats by and making sure that there's nothing toxic for them to eat, because she said then that obviously they don't want to do that. So if we get that going, we'll definitely take videos
pictures
for that. So stay tuned for goats in the backyard.
We'll take you to the other side and show you what I did over there. All right, so I had a wild hair up my ass the other day and I decided to shovel out all the leaves and the dirt that was over on this side of the house, which is unit B, and then I discovered a sidewalk. So let me show you what I did. Ah, it's a big mess of garbage right now, but this was about 6 to 8 inches of dirt and leaves and sand, and I started shoveling and I found sidewalk, which I was super surprised by, and it went all the way back. And eventually, the sidewalk revealed itself right to our shower, and then right back to the backyard, over here to our back patio over here. So, still needs a little cleaning up, but at the end of the day, huge discovery, and we're super excited about it. Gives us one less project to work on. We just gotta maintain it now. This is our outdoor shower. I'm not going to turn it on, but it does work. We will put something down here to catch all the water so it doesn't just turn into mud. But this is our outdoor shower. We're super excited. We have a little faucet down here in case you just need to rinse your feet off. So when you come visit us at the beach, you can rinse your feet before you come in the house. Come on in. Check out everything that we've done. It looks a million times better in here. Not sure where we left off last time, but if you haven't seen the floors look great. We've had the cabinets installed. just moved out, so it is brand spanking new to us to get into this unit. Nice big living area gives you a great idea of what we have to work with without all of our stuff in the way. We are still waiting for the countertops. I'm gonna be honest, the cabinets were not great. We did save money originally by going with a different company, but in retrospect, it was a terrible decision because the delays that they've caused have been the biggest headache that we've had in this entire project so far. But we did get the cabinets installed incorrectly, then they came back and fixed them, and now the countertops should be here on Tuesday. There is no dishwasher on this side, so a little more cabinet space, but no dishwasher, so we would definitely have to add a dishwasher in here. Same stove, same sink, very, very similar. Fridge, all that great stuff. Stove, appliances over here, everything looking really good. This is going to become an island where we can put seating over here.
You want to show them how it moves around?
Oh, the island moves around. Woo! Because if we would have put this island here without it moving on casters, you would have had to have made electrical run to the island. And that was not something we were really interested in. So as long as your island can move like a table, then it's totally fine to leave it as is.
So we've been busy the last probably week and a half, just doing all the painting. You can see we just finished putting in all the baseboards, all the trim around the doors, and painting it all. And that's been a big project.
Super white, bright white, just to make it look bigger.
It made it super easy to keep the baseboard and the walls all the same color, so you're not like cutting your lines, which was really nice. But yeah, I mean, super bright and open. You know, we're not sure if we're gonna have a dining room table space, so that's kind of another thing with having this on wheels. If we want, it will have the overhang, so if we want to move this around or someone, a guest wants to move it in a certain area for a dining table, I guess you could like wheel it over and watch TV. And
I can't imagine someone doing that.
Yeah.
But it will have an overhang so you can put stools underneath it.
But it might be better because there's not really a huge area for a dining room table, at least until we get a furnished, maybe there will be. I don't know. We'll just take you for a ride quick on the bedrooms. They are bright white and pretty basic.
Ready to be furnished.
But you can see this what the closet looks like. It's got the beadboard. It's all painted out.
I'm debating on whether or not to make these like a bright color just for funsies. So let us know in the comments if you think that would be smart or not.
We got the ceiling fan in. The second bedroom is basically the same. This is where we had some of our guests staying with us. When they were here, we had just the toilet operational, so they could have a bed and a place to stay, and then
and a toilet.
And a toilet. No shower, just a toilet at the time. And then this closet, again, is the same way with the beadboard.
Come check out my bathroom. If you remember, Eric did a little bit of a surprise. I was painting the bathroom. I wanted some color, a pop of color in here, something fun. So I made this mural, sort of. I don't know if you want to call it a mural. Come check it out, and then check out what Eric has done for me. So, these are my bright colors. I wanted something fun and exciting in here. And so we did like a sunburst with a bunch of different fun colors that are very beachy, but really staying with mostly the white theme and the main parts of the house. Eric did this entire tile. It's awesome. He did an amazing job. It has a little cutout over here so you can put shampoo and conditioner up there. But overall, really impressed with the work that he's done in this bathroom. And then last, we have a laundry room, and we have a washer and dryer here, stackable. And then we're gonna have to make cabinets, some kind of a shelving system over here, because there's no linen closet in here. And we definitely feel like we're gonna need to provide some space for people to do some storage, you know, soaps and laundry soap, dryer sheets, and actual sheets, that kind of stuff. Do you want to show them the mirror in the garage?
Oh, yeah.
I might need to turn the light on. I don't know where the light is. It's covered with stuff. You ready?
Yep.
So I got another well here at my house and decided to make a mural to see if I can make it look like watercolor. And then we did the No Bad Days logo, which we always think about John Greenwald, Eric's dad, because he used to tell us no bad days all the time. And so we did this as a little honor to him, because his spirit is always with us, especially as we're remodeling. He would have definitely been a fun part of this project had he been here.
That's it. That's what we've been up to the last 6 weeks or so. We are leaving for Arizona tomorrow.
Tomorrow morning.
We still got to pack, even though we're leaving in a couple hours, or we're going to bed in a couple hours and leaving in the morning.
Maybe I'll pack in the morning. We have to leave by 5:45 a.m.
Yeah.
Giving Rhonda Geraldine a heart attack right about now.
Our countertops should be installed while we're gone all next week. So when we get back, hopefully our countertops are installed, our kitchen sink, and then from there, all we just need to do is hook up the plumbing for the kitchen sink, the garbage disposal, the dishwasher, and then
move in.
We are moving in. So,
and then take two. We'll do the whole thing over on the other
yeah.
side.
I mean, there's even though we're moving in, there's still a lot of things that we got to do. Like, I got to replace all the window sills, clean and paint the windows, mostly on the outside. I know there's going to be, I got to finish off the laundry room. So there will be some projects, but you know, we can do that while we're living in here.
Yeah.
That'll make it a lot easier. Then we can get going on the next side as well. And then as we're working on the other side, then we'll also start working on the exterior. So we've picked out a paint color.
Infinite Deep Sea.
Is that it?
I think so. That's the color.
She just made that up.
No, right? I didn't. It's kind of like your shirt.
But,
it's a dark, it's
yeah.
dark blue. Infinite Deep Sea, I swear. That's what it is.
So we gotta paint the exterior, that'll be a big project, and then start working on the backyards, and...
Oh gosh, hopefully the next video has goats.
Yeah, so...
That'll be so fun.
Pray for goats and countertops, and then we will see you next time.
Yeah, thanks.
All right, see ya.